Dividing a number by 10, 100 and 1000. Teacher Nancy is in her class and she puts the question on the board. 46 divided by 10. 4 is the quotient or the answer and 6 is the remainder. Easy. Now, it's 247 divided by 100. Here also, 2 is the quotient and 47 is the remainder. This time, it's 4116 divided by 1000. Nancy ma'am says, simple. 4 is the quotient and 116 is the remainder. How easy it is! Dividing a 3-digit number by a 1-digit number.
Robbie Mouse is ready to divide 240 by 6. He uses the long method, puts the dividend and the divisor in place and gets the quotient 40. He writes the answer of the question, quotient 40. That was easy, Robbie.
Dividing a 4-digit number by a 1-digit number. Robbie Mouse has a new question. It is 5936 divided by 4. Robbie uses the long method. 4 can divide 5 once. So, 1 quotient and remainder 1. Copy 9. 4 divides 19 4 times. So, quotient 4, remainder 3. Copy the next digit 3. 4 divides 33 8 times. Quotient 8 and remainder 1. Copy the next digit 6. Now 4 divides 16 4 times. So quotient 4 and no remainder. The answer is 1484. Robbie now cross checks his answer. He multiplies 1484 by 4. Robbie has got 5936, the dividend of his first question. You are absolutely right, Robbie. Pattern in division. Teacher Nancy comes on the board. She writes 6 divided by 3 is equal to 2. 60 divided by 3 is equal to 20. It's easy to follow. 600 divided by 3 is equal to 200. As they add zeros to the dividend, zeros are also added to the quotient. 6000 divided by 3 will give 2000, and in the same way, 60,000 divided by 3 will give 20,000. If they add another zero to the dividend, the quotient will also have another zero, provided the divisor remains the same. Teacher Nancy now reverses the pattern in descending order. She begins by 600,000 divided by 3 is equal to 200,000. She asks the class, 60,000 divided by 3 is equal to 20,000. In the same way, you get 2,000, then 200, then 20, and finally 2.